So we have our products, the data itself, and those columns will be often referred to as attributes, but often different platforms and channels will favor a different term. If you're looking at a data table, you would refer to it as like the column or the field of data. An attribute can also be called a property. So depending on the software or system you're using, they might refer to it as something different, but what we're talking about are product attributes, stuff like color, material, size. Here, there's an example of what the customer sees. We're all familiar with browsing and filtering and searching for what we're shopping for using product attributes, even down to like, is it offered through Prime? That's an attribute. Some examples of required attributes would be the ID, the unique value that identifies that item, often called SKU. Then you'd have title, which is the product's name, price, the URL, the landing page on the store website, and there's so many more. Looking at how Google talks about attributes, Google has a product feed specification where they list out all the attributes that they accept down to the exact word. Do they accept the attribute name or do they accept the attribute title? It's the same concept, but in Google's world, they just said that attribute, we accept the word title or whatever that is. But another system like Amazon or something else could say, oh no, that attribute, we refer to it as name. So we want you to send that attribute as name, not title. So with the product specification, there's a link from Google in their docs where you can look at all of the specific fields. They even start with some general definitions that in their documentation, when you see the word product, they're referring to what the customer is thinking about, what they're searching for. But in their documentation, when they say the word item, that's like one of the rows in your data. On top of that, they have variants. And variants are just groups of items that vary based on some attribute, such as size or color. So with attributes, they can be grouped by types. With Google, they group them as basic product data, price and availability, category, product identifiers like UPC, all the way down to settings, stuff that makes your campaigns run, stuff that sets up what the shipping's supposed to cost or how the tax is collected. All of that can be product data attributes. And then when we talk about Amazon, Amazon has a different grouping, but it's similar stuff. They talk about required attributes versus the images versus attributes that refer to variation data, basic attributes, discovery, et cetera, even down to attributes talking about how it's fulfilled, whether it's through Amazon's warehouse or not, the offer data, like the price, and then even some attributes for B2B settings and configuration. And in our system, we have 19 standard fields or attributes, and then we have room for 200 custom attributes. You can set up anything in any way, and often it's to allow you to give a customer experience. An attribute could be as simple as a checkbox. Is it a yes, no? Or is it a radio option, like pick one option out of four? Or is it a multi-select, et cetera? So attributes obviously have data types that could be a number or a true false or multi-value, a list, et cetera. Data types affect the way that data gets processed, which we'll cover later.